Hi, my name is David Tu. I'm a test engineer at Agilent Technologies, and in our video today, I'm going to show you how to digitize using our 34411 DMM. The 34411 has a few additional features that are not available in our other DMMs. It's able to do 50,000 readings per second, has 1 meg of internal memory. It can do level triggering as well as pre and post triggering. So in our video today, we're going to show you a bunch of those features. So what I have on my bench here is I have a function generator that's connected to the DMM. The function generator is outputting a waveform right now. And just a brief description of the waveform. It's has about 1 second of noise. Then it's got a 2 volt pulse here, a little bit of delay. And then I'm following up with a 2 volt peak to peak sine wave. So that's currently being outputted. So what we're going to do is we're going to digitize that signal using this DMM and visualize that using Excel. So in order to do that, I'm just going to show you how to get that data using our web user interface that's built into the 34411. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get the IP address of the 34411. And I see here that the IP address is 169.254.4.10. So I'm going to bring that up in a web browser. 254.10. And now I'm already talking to the DMM. So I'm just going to click on web browser control and connect or allow full control here. So that allows me to control the DMM using this interface. Then I'm going to click on this button that says Control DMM and open up the Control DMM window. So the DMM settings right now are just the default state, so we're going to go through the setup in order to digitize a signal. So just in the measurement settings here, we have DC volts, 10 meg input resistance. We're actually going to set the range to be manual. Since we have a 2 volt signal on there, I'm going to set the range to be a 10 volt range. Auto zero off. Peak measurement off. And then in the integration time, you'll see a bunch of integration times. In the 34410, you won't be able to see that, but with the 34411, we have a bunch of fast integration times. So in this case, I'm going to put 0.002 PLC, which allows us to sample pretty fast but have fairly good accuracy. And then here in the trigger settings is actually where I'm going to set up the digitizing settings for the DMM. I'm going to set my trigger source to internal. And a positive slope, what I want to try to do is off of this waveform, I'm going to trigger off of this pulse, and I want to maybe set it to be about 1.5 volts. So let's do that here by setting the trigger level to 1.5 volts. And I want zero trigger delay. And say for the sample count, let's go ahead and just take 10,000 total samples. 3, 5. And from that sample count, I actually want to get a little bit of the noise here. So since I have about 1 second of noise here, that's about 2,000 samples. And my sample interval, since I have a 5 second waveform, I'm going to divide 5 seconds by 10,000 and get 500 microseconds. The voltmeter complete, I'm not going to care about, but I'll set that to positive. So I'm going to apply that to the DMM. And that's basically all the setup that you have to digitize, that you need to digitize. So in order to visualize the data, I'm going to say view data and then start my measurement. You'll see here in the view data window, I got 10,000 readings. So let's go ahead and read out our 10,000 readings and get the data. So you'll see here in this window, we have the data, but it really doesn't visually show us what we're trying to show. So I'm going to Control A to select all the readings and Control C to copy them, and then go into my Excel. And I've already got a couple of charts set up to visualize the data. And I'll plate paste that data in there with Control V. And here you'll see that this waveform matches pretty close what I have in outputting from my ARB. So I've got about a second of noise or pulse signal, the delay, and then our sine wave. And then in this little window up here, I'm just showing you that I did have a nice clean sine wave coming out of there. So that's all there is to digitizing with a 34411. I don't always digitize, but when I do, I use a DMM. Thank you very much.